Wake up call, Porta, April 18, 2015. I am here this morning to tell you of a new development in the RV, and the premier funds for the people. It is a time for all of you to assure yourselves that it will be coming at a time when it is perfect for all of those who have the quality of the earth and themselves in mind. There is one feature of these funds that is endearing to all of the universe, and it is that it will be in tune with what will be coming in the years ahead, and further on, that will come from the lessons that these times are giving you. There is plenty of time for them to materialize into the benefits that are in store for you. First, it is imperative that the ones who will be distributing are in a place in which there will be no interference. This is that time, my dear ones. This is the time that we have seen the various facets of the distribution being set into place with no possibility of interference. There is one point that I wish to make here, and that is that every moment brings about the creation of what is in the next moment. This is becoming very clear in these preparations for what is coming. As we go about our changes and see what comes from them, we are able to see what is being brought about through the insight that we each have. As I speak this through this one, I feel the instincts that she has to understand in live what I am saying. I feel it in so many of you, for you have lived what I speak of, and in that process there is a knowing that is activated with every moment and every experience that comes in that moment. I will give you an example. There was a person in the use of the funds that came about, and I speak now of the near future, who came to realize that there was so much in his mind about how he would use the funds he possessed that he began to wonder, what choices do I make? It was a process that he began by thinking of what he could do for others, and he went through that distribution to various ones he cared for in his life. Before he knew it, he was down to very little left for his own use. He pondered this reality and considered asking some of the ones he'd given money to for a return of some of it, but immediately he told himself, "No, that won't do. They have to come first, for it makes me look better in their eyes." He lived with that for a while, and after a time he realized he was not feeling good. He felt so left out and disregarded by his friends to whom he'd given the money. After more time he realized that he was his own worst enemy, for once he had given away what he considered to be the gauge of his worth, he no longer had any worth. At least that was what he felt. He thought of that for a while, and then suddenly realized how he felt about himself didn't have to do with the others. It was all about his feeling of self-worth. With that opening to himself, he began to feel much lighter. He knew that his worth was not all about what was outside of him to share with others, it was what was inside. He knew that what he had presented to them was not what he was all about. Now he knew that he could do anything, be anything that he wanted to be, and to have. All he needed to do was to feel self-love and the knowing that he needed nothing outside of himself to be able to have comfort in his life. Immediately after that he began to live differently. He felt the peace in his heart and the joy in his steps as he flowed through life. After some time, not too long, he began to notice wonders coming into his life. He greeted them with love and with gratefulness. He knew where some of them came from, and some of them remain a mystery to this day. The important thing for him was that he is now leading a life of peace, joy and love. He is now going to live the future in the way that means so much to him. Yes, I am saying that what you experience and learn from in the future and become so enlightened from it can affect your past in a way that can change your future and your past at the same time. This is further proof of what you've been hearing about there being no time. It is part of the illusionary world that you've been living in. This is the power you have to be in control of your life and to be in a constancy of peace. It is one of the riches that you are able to manifest in the twinkle of an eye. I tell you all this, I share it with you, because I love you so much. I see that you are at the brink of receiving the gifts that you give to yourself at the same time that the Creator gives it to you. It is a means by which, as they say, and it is such an interesting way to go through the process of ascension. You are the creators of your lives, and as you practice what you preach, you take yourself to another level. I am Porta, and I am one of the original Mashaba race. I come to you this day in a way that speaks of my love for all of you and to whisper in your ears of your power and love and creation. Go now and live your blessings, for you are the blessed. Thank you so much, dear Porta. Much love, Nancy Tate.